COVID-19 appropriate behavior. Students, there are three things you need to keep in your mind while moving out of your house. Number one, wearing mask. Wearing mask is mandatory and you should not forget to wear a mask when you move out of your house. It's one of the most important preventive measure you can take. Second is maintaining social distancing of 6 feet. When you are going out anywhere, make sure that you are standing away from others from 6 feet. At least 6 feet you are away from the others. Third is hand hygiene. Always carrying a sanitizer with you when you're going out and after coming back to home, before the entry, just make sure that you have a hand wash outside there. You can wash your hands and then enter inside. So students, these are the three things. If you adapt in your daily life, then there will be no harm to your family and of course to yourself. So I hope that you will follow these and have a good healthy life.
As we were doing this lesson, Madam Rice Divas, written by Vanni Karan. We were talking about Vanni's first journey on a bus ride when she took up a bus and she was mesmerized by the view that she saw inside the bus. It was a huge clock there. Then she saw lovely cushioned seats where she was sitting. And then she was really enjoying being sitting on a seat for the very first time on a bus. Let's move further. Vanni devoured everything with her eyes, but when she started to look outside, she found her view cut off by a canvas blind. Like you can see that if you want to look outside here, outside of your class, there are curtains here. Similarly, when she was sitting on a bus, there were canvas blind on the windows and it was kind of impossible for her to see, look outside, to look the sceneries outside. So what she did is, she stood up from her seat and started looking outside, started looking the sceneries outside. With this, she was startled by a voice that came from behind. And it was a voice of a man, of an elderly man. This man was really concerned about Vanni because it is quite risky for her to stand. She might hurt herself. There might be some bumps on the road or sudden breaks. So she might fall, might hurt herself. Therefore, this elderly man was really worried about the girl. Therefore, he told the girl to sit. But our Vanni, she was irritated and did not like the way the man spoke to her and she did not want to listen to him. But she sat down on the bus seat. There's nobody here who's a child. I have paid my 30 paise like everyone. So she replied to the man that she is not a child. No one here is a child. And she has even paid 30 paise for her seat. So, therefore, he did not speak anything to her. That is what she meant to say to the elderly man. The conductor chimed in. The conductor interrupted in between the conversation going on between the elderly man and Vanni. He said to Vanni, "Oh sir, this is a very grown-up matter. Do you think a mere girl could pay her own fare and that too 30 paise? And she is traveling all alone to the city." So the conductor told the elderly man in a very joking way, saying that she is not a child. She is a lady, she is a young woman who has paid 30. he has to give her a bus ticket, which he has not given up till now. So the bus conductor then punched her ticket and handed it to her, telling her, just sit down on the seat, be relaxed. After all, you have paid 30 paise for the seat. So please sit and relax. She replied to the bus conductor, I have paid 30 paise, but I want to stand. That is my choice. One, I don't want to sit, I want to stand. The bus conductor too was concerned about Vandi. She might fall, she might hurt herself. Therefore, he told her to sit. But she was not ready to listen to anyone. She had her own choices. She wanted to stand, she wanted to look outside. And she was shorter in height, a mere 8 girl. How could she possibly look outside of the window just by sitting on a seat? So it was very important for her to stand and look. But just after a few minutes, she saw a lot of passengers hurrying outside, hurrying on the bus in fear of losing her own seat. She thought that now a lot of passengers are coming and she might lose her seat if she didn't sit. So she cleverly sat down on her own seat, thinking that if she will not sit, then she will lose her seat. So she quickly sat down. Now, she was sitting, looking outside at beautiful sceneries. Then a lady came and sat beside her. When Vandi looked at the lady, she didn't like the lady at all. Why? Because she had huge earlobes. This is earlobe, okay? Where you put earrings. Where the girls and the boys put earrings. So these are earlobes. She had huge holes on her earlobes and she was wearing ugly earrings. This lady, this old woman, was wearing ugly earrings and she was chewing betel nut. What is betel nut? Yes. She was chewing betel nut and the juice of the betel nut was coming out of the corner of her lips and it looked very horrible to Vandi. She thought, how can someone be sociable to such kind of lady who is so horrible, who is chewing so horribly and not looking good at all, wearing those huge earrings, ugly earrings, and chewing betel nut, and it is looking horrible. How can someone be friends with her? How can someone talk to her? How can someone be sociable with her? But when this lady told Vandi, asked Vandi that, are you all alone here? Are you going alone? So Vandi had to reply, it doesn't look fine. So she had to reply, she said, yes, I am traveling alone and I have got a ticket too. She showed the ticket to the lady and told that yes, she is going alone and she has a ticket of her own too. The bus conductor, somewhere around from the bus, again came between the conversation going on between Vandi and the old woman and said, yes, she is on her way to town with a 30 paise ticket. So with a 30 paise ticket has been mentioned again and again by Vandi as well as to the bus conductor. Bus conductor was just mimicking her. After every time, whenever she spoke to anyone that she has a 30 paise ticket, he would come out of nowhere to repeat what Vandi says, that yes, she has a 30 paise ticket. Oh, why don't you mind your own business, said Vandi to the bus conductor. And it was a very funny moment for both of them. Vandi also started laughing, the bus conductor also started laughing. So they both started laughing. But the old woman who was sitting beside Vandi, she continued with her driver. Driver means silly nonsense. She continued with her lots and lots of questions to be asked from Vandi. She continued asking questions from her, which irritated Vandi a lot. The questions were, is it proper for such a young person to travel alone? Do you exactly What's the street? What's the house number? So it's quite obvious when somebody sees a very small girl, 7 or 8 years old, an elderly person who is concerned, an elderly person who is very curious to know whose child is this, small girl. So anybody would ask questions from this one. But Valmi, being very smart and clever, she didn't like being asked questions from different people around her. She had her own choices. She thought in her mind that she had been planning it for months and months. She had kept every single point in her mind before going on a journey, and who these people asked to ask questions from her when she had been preparing it for months and months. She had sacrificed a lot for this journey, for this first journey. She's quite attentive for everything. She can take care of herself. Who these people are to ask from her? She had sacrificed toffees, chocolates, balloons, and even a merry-go-round swing also. She sacrificed all these things and collected every single penny, every single coin that came her way through different sources, through parents, through relatives, or through anyone she got coins from. She collected those coins. She sacrificed everything. And now people are asking her where you are going, why you are going, what's the street number and all these things. She didn't like that at all. And even I think most of you also don't like being questioned by others again and again, repeating the same answer again and again. So she was really fed up with the questions of the lady. Now, as mentioned in the book, that she has collected the money from the different sources and she had been collecting it for months and months, and it was around 60 paise. She had almost collected 60 paise for the journey. Now the next question arises in her mind, that now at what time she should slip out of her house. And this was not the biggest issue in her life about going out, because after lunch, her mother would always take a nap every day, and that suitable time was 1 to 4 p.m. 1 to 4 p.m. This was the time when Valmi would use these hours for excursions in the village. She would go outside, she would look at different people, she would look at the passengers, she would roam around the whole village. So this had been, these hours were perfect for her, as she had been exposing previously also, and now it was the best time for her to slip out and go in this particular hours to go on a bus journey. Now, after collecting money for days, for months and months, now the final day has arrived. Finally, the day has arrived when she was absolutely ready to go for a bus journey. Now, one day she was waiting outside her house at the same time at one outside her house for the bus.
About to gobble up the other vehicle beside and the pedestrians, the people
continued the bus journey. Now, they reached at the railway crossing. Finally, they reached at the railway crossing. They saw a train passing by, and as the train passed by, the loud voice, the loud voice of the train just shaken up the bus on which she was sitting. The loud roar of the train, it shook up the whole bus, and then it passed, and the bus went on and passed the train station. From there, it travels a busy lane out shopping street and turning into a wider thoroughfare. Such big, bright looking, what glittering displays of clothes and other merchandise, such a big crowd. So after passing the railway crossing, they reached a lovely market. She looked around and she found mesmerizing, lovely, glittering shops filled with lights. She saw clothes, she saw merchandise, she saw lovely stalls, eating stalls, she saw juices, tea stalls, and everything. And the market was full of lights. And she had been to the market first time ever in her life. She had never been outside of the village before. This was the first time she was outside of the village all alone. And this was lovely to see for her, as it was her first alone journey that she had been to the market. She looked around and she was lost in the, she was lost looking outside. The bus conductor saw that all the passengers have gone, and now only one passenger was left. It was Vandi. She kept on sitting on the chair, on the cushion, the seat of the bus. She was actually glued on the seat. Now the bus conductor asked Vandi that the town is here, the last stop is here, why don't you go now? Vandi said, no, I do not want to go. I have taken up this bus journey just to have a look around, and now I want to go back home. She put one hand inside her pocket, took another 30 paise and gave to the bus conductor and told, now this is my 30 paise for the return journey, give me a ticket. The bus conductor was really surprised that she came all the way from the village covering kilometers, and now she's saying she wants to go back. How this is possible? So he told her, okay, if you do not want to go anywhere, just come out and have a look. You can go to a stall, just take a round and come back. Vandi was scared. Vandi told conductor, no, I cannot go because I'm alone. I fear going alone and all by myself I will go. No, it's not possible. The bus conductor was shocked that few minutes before, Vandi only told that she is quite confident that she's alone and she doesn't like to get disturbed by anyone. She's traveling alone and now she's scared of being alone. How this is possible? Few minutes before she was very confident and now she's saying that she fears going outside all alone. So, okay, he told, okay, fine. Just go and have a juice. Go and have a cold drink. She told, I cannot have the cold drink because I do not have money. I had 60 paise and not more than that, and I cannot have a cold drink. The bus conductor was really kind. He asked Vandi, okay, I will provide you a drink. It will be my treat. This treat will be from my side. I will provide you a drink. To which Vandi replied, no, I do not want any drink. Thank you so much. Please take me back home. Now, I do not want to drink anything. The bus conductor kind of stopped himself from going, as Vandi was not ready to have drink at all. So, after even in the return journey, the passengers were very few. The bus started to move. "Won't your mother be looking for you?" the conductor asked when he gave the girl her ticket. So, the bus conductor asked Valli that your mother would be really concerned about you. Won't she be looking about you? Won't she be looking for you? She said, "No, no one will be looking for me," because she was very, very sure that her mother would be sleeping. Her mother would be taking a nap, and there was nobody at home, as mentioned here. There was nobody at home, and she was sure that her mother will not be looking for her, because these hours she had used earlier also for roaming around in the town, and her mother never tried to find her. So she was 100% sure that this time also her mother would not be finding for her, and she was quite relaxed about it. Valli wasn't bored in the slightest and greeted everything with the same manner as she started her journey. Generally what happens that when we come back from the same route, it becomes slightly boring for us. But for Valli, it was not a single person less of the excitement that she had before. She had the same excitement for the bus journey, for the return journey, and like before. She was enjoying, she was looking outside, she was looking here and there, everything she could look, her eyes could see, she could see as far as her eyes could see. She was kind of enjoying every moment of her life that time. Now, her eyes fell on a dead body, on a dead body of a cow. When she looked at the dead body, she was deeply saddened by the view. She asked the bus conductor, "Isn't it the same cow that we had seen while coming on the journey?" The bus conductor nodded his head like this, and she understood that yes, it was the same cow. She looked away from the window. She sat quietly on a seat, and her heart was filled with sadness. She did not look outside anymore. Her excitement, everything went into vain. It was almost completely finished, because her heart filled with sadness. What had been a lovely, beautiful creature just a while ago, and now this lovely creature has been turned into a dead body and into a horrible one, because vehicle might have hit the car, and the dead body was lying in a pool of blood. And when she looked at it, she didn't like at all. The memory of the dead car kept on haunting her throughout the journey, throughout the return journey, and she couldn't keep her mind away from that pool of blood and the dead body of the car. Therefore, she sat quietly and waited for her home to come as soon as possible. Now she was missing home, and she wanted to go back to her house. She turned to the conductor. Valli finally reached at her place. Both conductor and Valli greeted each other. Valli told conductor that she hopes that she would be seeing him some other day, the same bus. The conductor also hoped the same for Valli. "Okay, madam," gossips with her mother. She was least bothered about the answer. Said, Valli knew that my aunt doesn't want the answer from me, so she just smiled. And they thought that Valli would be somewhere here and there only, not far out. So they were okay about it and they continued their conversation. Valli's mother was talking to Valli's aunt that so many things are in our midst and in the world outside. How can we possibly know about everything? And even when we do know about something, we often can't understand it completely, can we? So they were talking about something really important. They were talking about that there are things in our life. There are things that are happening right now, but we aren't aware of. There might be things happening outside this auditorium, this hall, we aren't aware of. Many things are happening inside our school, we aren't aware of. And even if we are aware of, even if we hear voices coming from different ways, but we do not understand what is actually going. So they were talking, they were having their elderly talk with each other, that there are a lot of things going in this world, in the corner of different countries, but we aren't aware of. And even if we are aware of, even if we get to know about it from television or from newspaper or from anywhere, but we don't understand that what is actually happening in this world. And Valli interrupted and said, yes, absolutely. Valli's mother asked Valli, yes, what did you say? Valli said, oh no, I was just agreeing to what you are saying. I'm just agreeing that many things are happening with our knowledge, without our knowledge. Yes, it is happening. And Valli smiled. Behind the smile, there was something really big. Behind that smile was her own bus journey that her mother and her aunt wasn't aware of. She took 2 to 3 hours of bus journey her mother didn't know about. And she was quite agree what we both were discussing about, and that just happened few minutes before. She took a long journey and her mother and her aunt aren't aware about it. So, said, I was just agreeing with what you said about things happening without our knowledge. Just a chit of a girl she is, said her aunt. Chit of a girl means immature. Yet look, she pokes her nose into a conversation just as though she were a grown lady. So, you know, it's a good habit when two people, when two elders are talking, not to interrupt him, not to interrupt in between. It is known to be as a good manner. But here, when both of them were talking, one they interrupted, to which her aunt didn't like and said, she is a chit of a girl. How immature she is. She is poking her nose in our conversation. And she is speaking as if she were a grown lady. As if she has grown so much big that she is poking her nose in a conversation between us. Valli smiled to herself. She knows that she is clever. She knows that she is smart. She understands everything. She understands what aunt is saying to her. She understands what mother is talking to her. So behind that smile, there are a lot of things going on in the mind of Valli, though the elders are not able to understand what is going on in her mind. They think Valli to be immature. But was she immature? No. She was mature in her own way. She was smarter than anyone. But didn't she? She didn't want them to understand her smile. But then there wasn't much chance of that, was there? So she was smiling, but she didn't want to want the elders to understand what is behind her smile. She didn't want the aunt and her mother to know about her bus journey. She didn't want to share anything with them. Obviously, she knew that if she's going to share, she will get scoldings. or she might get beaten up by her mother. So she didn't want to share with them. But do you think there